What is space? It looks like this is nothing. So how do you make sense of something that looks like nothing? It is still one of the deepest mystery in physics. Hello everyone, my name is Ayush Agarwal and that's my YouTube channel. Do subscribe and remember to press the bell icon for interesting videos, facts and the latest updates. Let's begin. If I say, how far have you been? Not much, but today we are going to travel way beyond our beautiful Mother Earth. I always used to think, what if we remove all this stuff away from Earth? I mean, not just the people, cars, buildings, but the Earth itself. What if we took away all the planets, stars, galaxies, and not just the big stuff, but the tiny atoms of gas and dust? What if we took it all away? What would be left? Have you ever thought about it? Most of us would say nothing, and we'll be right, but strangely, we'll be wrong. What's left is an empty space. An empty space is not nothing, it's something. Something with hidden characteristics as real as all the stuff in our daily lives. In fact, space is so real that it can bend, can twist, and space can ripple. So real that empty space itself helps shape everything in the world around us and forms the every fabric of the cosmos. So if we talk about the tallest building in the world since 2008, which is about 828 meters tall, Burj Khalifa holds the record. And let's say we take out all this space out of it, we will be left with a little lump of about the size of a grain of a rice, but weighing hundreds and millions of pounds. The rest is only empty space. In 16th century, there was a rise of the first English physicist astronomer Isaac Newton, who is widely recognized as one of the most influenced scientists of all time. This is how the father of modern science pictured space as an empty stage. The action done on the stage could not affect stage, and the stage could not affect the action either. By picturing space in this way, Newton was able to describe the world as no one has ever done before. His unchanging stage allowed him to understand almost all the motions we can see around us, from falling an apple to the rotation of the moon around the earth. He told us that there is some force that is pulling the apple from the tree, which we know as gravity or gravitational force. Now Newton thought that the moon is also pulled towards Earth by this gravitational force, and so is the Earth with respect to the sun. He gave the first formula in which gravity is an instantaneous force. It proves that if you make the mass zero, the force of gravity will automatically become zero. Let's take an example from the space. Over here, the force of gravity of sun is constantly acting on the earth. And this phenomena is termed as an instantaneous force. Now, if the sun disappears, our earth at the same time will start moving on a straight path rather than revolving around the sun. Earth will start freezing, but it will all happen at the same time. Let's say if the sun disappears at 11:11, the earth at the same time, 11:11, will start moving on the same path. Newton's stage was a huge hit. It enjoyed the limelight for over 200 years. But in the early decades of the 20th century, a new set of ideas emerged that proves Newton's theory wrong. His name, Albert Einstein. Einstein grew up in the late 1800s at the dawn of the age of electricity. Electric power was lighting up cities, giving rise to all kinds of technologies Newton could never have imagined. So how does Einstein prove Newton's theory wrong? To demonstrate this, let's go on a ride. Now, when you're traveling fast, not only you can actually feel that change, but you can see the speed of the vehicle in the speedometer or on one of those radar speed signs on the roads. So let's stop and imagine, instead of measuring the speed of light, you have a radar sign that measures the speed of light coming out of its headlights. That sign would measure the light traveling at a constant 671 million miles per hour. The speed of light is same for everybody. And that's really extraordinary. Einstein gave an example to demonstrate space-time, and that's how he became Einstein. He took an example of the pool table to demonstrate space-time. It is so flexible that it could stretch like an actual fabric. Now think of this table as a space-time, and all the balls as the objects in the space. Now if I put something heavy on this stretchy space-time fabric, and if I take my shot, watch what happens. The ball will travel along the circumference that the heavier object creates, and that's how the gravity works. In other words, gravity is space-time itself. In fact, gravity in space is also a space-time itself. The moon is pulled not because of an instantaneous force which Newton told us about, but rather it rolls around the space-time fabric that the Earth creates. With this theory of Einstein, space had many properties. Something flexible kind of geometry, almost like a rubber sheet. Einstein told that light takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach Earth. So let's look at the previous situation where sun goes black or disappear according to Einstein's theory. If the sun disappears at 11:11, light will take 8 minutes or more to affect the Earth, where in Newton's story he told that the moment sun disappears, everything will stop and it will be the end. So with this conclusion, I'm ending this video. Hope you guys enjoy it and I'm dropping the link in the description for the world's first space nation, Asgardia. It is world's first space station to be created by any human. Scientists have been able to understand the law behind the force of gravity. Stay updated for my next video on Asgardia. I mean, it's actually cool living in space. I'm already bored with an Earth. Thanks for watching. You can follow my Instagram account, RoyalBlack07, or Google it for more updates. Stay updated, stay tuned. Peace out.